Tonight we continue the tradition that is Miss Florida. It's pageantry, but it's our style, our way. As we take the first step to Miss USA. Hey, announcer, kick it.
From the city of Hollywood, it's the Miss Florida USA pageant. Now, let's meet the contestants competing for the premier title in the Sunshine State. Mr. Director, are you ready?
Cue the contestants.
From the sound stages of Hollywood, let's meet tomorrow's stars, starting with...
5, 6, 7, 8.
From Naples, Laura Lynn Watson. Chelsea Ann Zeter from Orlando. Krista Ballard from Ocala. Representing Tampa, Kay Franchelle Jimison. April Gregory from Cape Coral. From Panama City Beach, Kristen Dern. Erica Valdez representing Jacksonville. Representing Daytona Beach is Carrie Miwong. From Avon Park, Carrie Anderson. Shelby Burns from St. Petersburg. From Dufuniak Springs, Erica Macon. Melanie Hill from Jacksonville. From Tampa, Carlicia Martin. Tracy Nielsen from Celebration. From Orlando, Jamie Cross.
And stand by, cue the contestants.
As they hit their mark, here is Shannon Smith, representing Orlando. From Parkland, Marissa Lee. Arlene Rivera from Hollywood. From Miami, Tasha Nicole. From Gainesville, Alicia Salmon. Susanna Garcia from Miami. From Tampa, Barbara Del Pilar. Hiroshima Kindling from Miami. Rachel LaFortune from Fort Lauderdale. From Hialeah, Noelle Iglesias. Melissa Chediak from Cooper City. Representing Broward, Danielle Watson. From Miami, Lindsay Shockey.
We cue the contestants.
And now, let's meet the remaining group after my title. Beginning with Candace Jolly from Naples. From Tallahassee, Petty Spoon. Angela D. Sawyer from Apopka. From Tallahassee, Elizabeth Stevens. Anna Maria Rodriguez from Miami. From Miami, Shannon Ford. Rebecca Attila from Fort Myers. Shayna Ray Green from Orlando. From Panama City Beach, Amy Nicole Bonfour. Robin Kay from Pompano Beach. From Umatilla, Jacqueline Nesbitt. Desiree Weeks from Brooksville. From Tampa, Lillian Mauricia Sampson.
The 2002 Miss Florida USA pageant is brought to you by the City of Hollywood, the Diamond of the Gold Coast, the Greater Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, and Golf Hollywood.
You've just met the premier young ladies of the Sunshine State, all aiming for my crown. Yes, truly women on a mission. The competition begins at the Miss Florida USA 2002 pageant. I love the excitement.
I wanted to be a nurse since I was 6, but I was a little afraid about moving away to go to college. So when I found I could get my degree and still live at home, I registered at BCC the next day. Now I'm a nurse with a good job. Gracias, BCC.
An associate degree from BCC can put you to work in just 2 years. Learn the skills you need to get the job you want. Registration is going on now. Want to go? Got a call. Broward Community College, opening doors to a brighter future.
Let the games begin. It's the 2002 Miss Florida USA pageant, featuring 41 of Florida's premier young women competing for the title. Tonight's host comes all the way from Deco Drive and soon to be seen on the made-for-TV movie The Suitor. He's Louis Aguirre. Our hostess is international television personality Idalmis Vidal. And providing expert pageant commentary is international singer and dancer Kristen Ludicky.
Wow, what a crowd! crowd. How you folks doing out there? Oh, this is going to be a good show.
It's going to be wonderful.
This is going to be a really good show. First of all, I got to tell you, this is one of the best gigs a guy can have in television. You're surrounded by 41 of some of the most beautiful ladies in our state, not to mention my two lovely ladies in red, my co-hosts.
Thank you.
This rocking audience, which is unbelievable so far.
It is.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And we got some lively competition coming up, so just you wait.
Definitely. You know, you're a very, very lucky man, but you're not the only one. You guys are very lucky because you're in for a night full of flair, fashion, and a lot of competition.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. Swimsuits, evening gowns, all of the traditional excitement you expect from a pageant, but featuring women who are anything but traditional.
Oh, no, they're not, Kristen. On this stage, we have the leaders of tomorrow, all with the drive and capability to do whatever challenges them.
That's right. And Miss Florida USA, we're dedicated to furthering the ideals and goals of women today.
But we're not above having some fun. And tonight is going to be a blast, isn't it? That's it. But you know what, Louie? We've got a very special person that is missing here tonight.
I can't believe this crowd, first of all. You guys are great.
I'm excited.
But we have a very special person to bring out before we start the competition, and that is our reigning queen, the very beautiful, the very talented Julie Donaldson, Miss Florida USA 2001. Julie. There she is. Give it up, folks, Julie Donaldson.
This is the part I really, really love. We are ready to choose the delegate who will be Miss Amity. The girls have spoken, and Miss Amity is nervous. Okay. Jacqueline Neshwat. Congratulations, Jacqueline.
Congratulations, Jacqueline. You know, that's a very important award because that award is actually given by the contestants, and they choose the lady that has been the best friend there with the thimble and the thread if needed, and I'm sure it's well deserved.
And I'll tell you, that's a lot of what pageants are about, is making new friends and being a support system for everyone. So it's definitely an award to be cherished. Well, you know what? After my year as Miss Florida USA, I headed into the world of entertainment, as many of these contestants will follow in that same path. This is why Miss Photogenic is so very competitive and an honored award within its own right. Julie, tell us a little bit about that.
The 411 on Miss Photogenic is whoever wins tonight follows in the footsteps of some pretty successful alumni. Former Miss Florida USA Photogenic Award winners include actress Jennifer Beanie and Star Search winner Barbara Bond. This year's journalists covered fashion shows, modeling segments, and press photo day held poolside at the Comfort Inn in Hollywood. And the contestants drew the attention of the press worldwide. So many great looks to choose from and only one award to give. We put the pressure on the press as they alone vote on who will be tonight's winner. Kristen, I gotta tell ya, I'm modeling for a living now, but I sure wish I would have won this award.
Me too, Julie. You know, the next contestant to follow in that tradition is Miss Photogenic 2002, Robin Kay.
Congratulations, Robin.
Congratulations, Robin. Miss Photogenic 2002. I bet we'll be looking for her name and face in our favorite magazines in the near future.
Absolutely. And what a great way to start this evening of pageantry. Two outstanding winners well on their way to reaching success. And up next for 15 worthy contestants is the first step towards winning the crown. The announcement of the semifinalists is just around the corner.
Well, and nerves behind us, you know, they're at an all-time high. And I tell you, that's a lot of nerves from experience. I know
feeling.
That.
So it's about time for us to get to our anchor positions.
Okay.
Enjoy the pageant, everyone. We'll see you a bit later.
You.
We'll see you, ladies. I'll miss you, too. All right, ladies. As you head to your hostess positions and we head to commercial, here's some Miss Florida USA trivia.
As an aspiring actress, I think it's cool that past Miss Florida USA alumni include such personalities as Victoria Principal, Delta Burke, Mary Margaret Humes of Dawson's Creek, and movie actress Jennifer Beanie. Maybe one day I'll be on that list. But next on our list is the announcing of our semifinalists here at Miss Florida USA 2002.
Winning the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant was like a dream. The prizes, the glamour. Being in the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant is awesome. And a $40,000 college scholarship ensures my college education. Yes, a $40,000 scholarship for college. Check out MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the details. So surf the web, enter online, and that could be you wearing my crown.
Get ready to move. It's time to submit to the rhythm with Pulse. Two CDs or two cassettes of nonstop throbbing energy. You can't get this 30-track collection in any store. It's a beautiful life. Oh, oh. You know you're gonna be mine. Finally, it's happened to me. Right in front of my face. Baby, if you want me, you have to show me love. Body lover, wanna be body lover. What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Feel the pulse. And get it now. To order, call the number on your screen. Two CDs, $26.99. Two cassettes, $21.99.
Want to keep up with all the latest information on Miss Florida USA? MissFloridaUSA.com has everything you need to know at one site. Preliminary pageant links, information, contestant applications, the latest Miss Florida USA news, and of course, behind-the-scenes photos. Then visit our Miss Florida Teen USA page at MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the latest on our sister pageant. So, for the latest pageant info, just find us at MissFloridaUSA.com, the coolest pageant site on the internet.
All right. We're here live. Bailey Concert Hall is rocking as months of hard work will pay off for 15 young women. Julie, how did we get here?
Louie, it started on Tuesday at the Spring Hill Suites where the competition began. True, the contestants arrived at the pageant on Tuesday, but they have been busy for months, training and preparing for pageant week. For the first time, six preliminary pageants were held this year as entryways into tonight's competition. The remainder of the field entered via MissFloridaUSA.com and met the eligibility requirements from our home office. Then they competed Thursday in the preliminary interview segment. Friday night's competition featured contestants in swimsuits and evening gowns of their own choosing. And now Louie has the results of the preliminary judging competition. Is this tough stuff or what?
Oh, it is so tough. It's the toughest job around right now, and that's picking the 15 outstanding ladies of this group. Life is full of tough decisions. The judges have spoken, and here they are. Our first semi-finalist is April Gregory from Cliff Coral. Our second semi-finalist is Robin Kay of Pompano Beach. Give it up for Barbara Del Pilar. She's semifinalist number three from Tampa. Our fourth semifinalist is Shannon Louise Smith, representing Orlando. Semifinalist number five, Kristen Lee Duran from Panama City Beach.
Our sixth semifinalist is Erica Valdez, representing Jacksonville. Lucky seven is Krista Gail Ballard from Ocala. We got eight more to go, and we'll start with Shanna Ray Green from Orlando. Number nine is Jacqueline Neshwat from Umatilla. Give it up for number 10, Amy Nicole Bonfleur from Panama City Beach. Our 11th semifinalist is Danielle Wasser, representing Broward County. We got four more to go, and we'll start with Melanie Hill from Jacksonville. Lucky 13 is Shelby Burns from St. Petersburg. Number 14, Carrie Ann Miwa from St. Petersburg. We've got one more contestant remaining in the top 15, and she is Shannon L. Ford from Miami. There they are, yes, your 15 semifinalists representing the best of Florida. All vying for the crown of Miss Florida USA 2002. Give it up. Ladies in the balcony, take it away.
Well, definitely the toughest competition in the Sunshine State.
You know, all week long, the competition has led up to tonight's top 15 contestants being announced. The field has been narrowed, everything has been erased, and the competition will be renewed on the stage in swimsuits, evening gowns, and interview competition.
You know, but you will also be able to pick your favorite. You just go straight to our website, MissFloridaUSA.com.
Adamus, tonight's winner will follow in our footsteps onto the Miss USA pageant and then maybe onto Miss Universe. You never know.
You know, I had such a great time representing Florida at Miss USA.
Me too. But, you know, tonight we're representing our host city of Hollywood.
And out representing and having all the fun a reigning queen should have is our Julie Donaldson, all in South Florida's newest hotspot.
You are so right, Adamus. Hollywood is swinging. And I'm here at Downtown Hollywood Nights, a weekly celebration of arts, food, shopping, and music. As I am the queen, I've sent our contested reporters out to do all the hard work, checking out Downtown Hollywood. Ladies, are you up to the task?
Julie, when it comes to shopping, I'm always up for the task. Now, excuse me, I see a great outfit over there.
And here on Harrison Street, they have everything to make a beauty queen happy. From great clothes to a furniture design district, it's all in Hollywood.
You know, I'm just exhausted thinking of all the shopping possibilities.
True, true. All that shopping can work up quite an appetite. Right, Desiree?
It's a tough time to be competing in swimsuits, and that's for sure. I'm here doing the healthy food thing at Try My Thai. And when I come back, it's sushi. No, Italian. Mexican? It's so hard to choose. All I can tell you, Julie, is it's all about healthy eating for me this week. It's all about the discipline.
You gotta admire the effort. For a more, shall we say, modernistic approach, here's our resident artist, Krista.
I am here with my people. Art's all around me.
Julie, you know I've checked out all the galleries in downtown Hollywood, getting inspiration for my work.
I see. It's like Monet in the making.
It's impressionistic, and my inspiration is definitely the crown. So what do you think?
It'll look great over my couch. I'll take it. And how about some great live music?
Wouldn't be a party without it. I'm here sitting in on some smooth jazz at Ellington's, but this is about my sixth stop tonight.
It began with a cool running reggae band playing on Harrison Street, a little folk on Hollywood Boulevard, and then some dancing at Deco Drive.
Hey guys, play your best stuff because I'm talking to Miss Florida USA. Julie, what do you think?
I think I just found a great place to hang. Adelmas and Kristen, we've got to come back after the pageant. Well, I've got to get some rest. We're off to the beach next. It is good to be the queen.
I wanted to be a nurse since I was six, but I was a little afraid about moving away to go to college. So when I found I could get my degree and still live at home, I registered at BCC the next day. Now I'm a nurse with a good job. Gracias, BCC.
An associate degree from BCC can put you to work in just 2 years. Learn the skills you need to get the job you want. Registration is going on now. Want to go? Got a call. Broward Community College, opening doors to a brighter future.
Welcome back to Miss Florida USA 2002, a true summertime tradition. The opportunities for tonight's winner are great. The same opportunities are available to outstanding teenagers of the Sunshine State, thus the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant.
You know, it's a fun-filled October weekend in Charlotte County. We're so proud of our reigning queen, Joanna Candelaria, and we thought we'd tell you her story and let you check out our sister pageant as well.
And then check out more at MissFloridaTeenUSA.com.
I just couldn't believe that I was actually there. Like, part of my dream was coming true. I was actually up there with the last two. It was just really exciting. It was really a moment of joy.
This is what Miss Florida Teen USA is all about. Every October, the pageant takes place on the Gulf Coast in Charlotte County. The contestants enjoy what is truly an event to remember. From the excitement of the television pre-tapings to the staged and televised competition, this event is just like its sister pageant, but with a twist that the natural Florida of Charlotte County offers. The contestants have the chance to enjoy what makes the region special. As always, the emphasis is on fun. This is why the pageant appeals to so many sides of a young woman, even before the competition begins.
They really bring themselves out, and I think that's actually one of the benefits, that your personality grows and just everything about you grows into a greater experience when you do things like this.
This is why Miss Florida Teen USA is unique. This event is not just about the title, it's about the young lady competing. Not to mention the opportunities that come with winning the title, such as a $40,000 college scholarship to Johnson & Wales, the opportunity to appear on statewide television, and the chance to compete at the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant.
And even if you don't win a crown, it's just a wonderful thing, the feeling that you get inside of yourself, knowing that you did this and that you've tried, and just getting that far, getting to participate and be a contestant in a pageant is just a wonderful thing. And I think people leave pageants feeling really, really good about themselves, and they have a positive attitude.
And what a positive attitude our Joanna has. This aspiring podiatrist and ballet dancer is on her way to Miss Teen USA, but it's the memories of a special year that will always be with her.
I think in 20 years, I would definitely probably look back on this and say, you know, well, this was one thing in my life that, you know, really impacted my life, and it was a goal that I set and I achieved it. And then I'll be going on to set another goal in my life with my career, and I would just say, you know what, I did it then and I can do it now.
Yes, you can, girl. Presenting Joanna Candelaria, Miss Florida Teen USA.
It's when you can provide an opportunity to a young lady like Joanna. You know, that is really what pageantry is all about.
That's right, Chris. And pageantry is also about fashion and flair. You know, the fun stuff.
I like that.
I know you do. And what could be more fun than a fashion show? At the invitation of Hollywood's Clothing District, contestants hit the catwalk at an event we call Beauty and the Beach.
Julie went to capture the fashion show and bring it back for the pageant fans. She always gets the fun assignments. Oh, well.
When it comes to international fashion, Miss Florida USA is always at the cutting edge. I'm here at Hollywood's Beauty and the Beach Fashion Show, waiting for the Miss Florida USA contestants to hit the runway. And as you probably already know, they are all supermodels in the making. But first, for some of that backstage action, I went behind the scenes to get the inside scoop, and let me tell you, it sure does feel like Fashion Week here. The event is a fundraiser featuring the leading fashions of Hollywood and our contestant models. They were wardrobed and fitted with attire ranging from formal to casual. Let's check out the clothes. I love this outfit on you. It looks great. It compliments you. Tell me about the accessories you picked out.
Well, I have the gold hoop earrings and the gold chain and the flower, and it's all from Purple Rain.
With the summer heat, Erica here is ready with her beach wear, and notice the Hollywood Florida hat. When you're picking a color for fashion, it's very important to complement your hair, your skin color, your eyes with the colors that you're wearing. Arlene has picked neutral earth tones. It looks great on her, and we can't wait to see you on the runway. The lights are down and the show's about to begin. Let's go to the stage. After a welcome by the mayor of Hollywood, the scene was set. An evening of fashion.
Push the tempo, 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 push the tempo.
Model title. And now we get back to crowning the next Miss Florida USA. The semifinalists begin the interview competition. Up next on Miss Florida USA 2002.
Winning the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant is like a dream. The prizes? The glamour. Being in the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant is awesome! And a $40,000 college scholarship ensures my college education. Yes, a $40,000 scholarship for college. Check out MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the details. So surf the web, enter online, and that could be you wearing my crown.
Welcome back to the 2002 Miss Florida USA pageant.
Our first phase of competition is the interview segment, a showcase of the contestants' education and ability to think on their feet.
This is where the judges can be wooed by the contestants' intellect. Sometimes the entire competition can be won with an outstanding interview.
That's right. The new Miss Florida USA will have a year of interviews, press conferences, and some serious networking. So, with a world-class interviewer like Louis on the scene, let's see what the semifinalists have to say. Louis?
I'm looking forward to that as well. And the competition is going to start right now as I introduce our first semifinalist back onto the stage. That is April Gregory from Cape Coral. There you are, April. How you doing?
I'm great. How are you, Louis?
Good. Are you ready for your question?
Yes.
All right, here goes. What do you feel is the greatest challenge that women face today?
Well, I think the greatest challenge that women face today is really getting their start in schools and in education. I believe that sometimes we feel that people put women at a disadvantage because they're women and because they think of them as, like in beauty pageants, as just pretty beauties and not that we have the brains, and I'm here to say that we do, and I'm a leading example of one of them.
Yes, you are. And I wish you all the luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, April. Let's bring out our second semifinalist, Robin Kay. Hi, Robin.
How are you?
Very good, thanks very much. You must be on cloud nine right now.
I am, I'm having a good night.
Yes, you are. You ready for your question?
I am.
Okay, your question is, what has been the biggest disappointment in your life and how did you handle it?
Wow, that is such a difficult one because I believe that my life is totally planned out, so every disappointment is actually a positive thing. And I actually learned so much more from my disappointments. And I think that being a first runner-up last year here was a bit of a disappointment to come so close. But I think it was good because I took a very close look at my life and got things together.
And you came back and tried to do it again.
Absolutely.
So we wish you luck tonight. Thank you, Robin.
Thank you.
All right, Robin Kay. Hello, Barbara Del Pilar.
How are you, Luke?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good. I'm very excited to be here.
Okay, I have a question for you. What has been the most valuable lesson your parents have taught you, and how has that lesson helped you today?
The most valuable lesson my parents have taught me has been to reach for the stars. I have been able to complete my college education because of this, and I believe that it's a very valuable lesson that I want to pass on to my children as well. And when you can reach for the stars and you set your goals high, I think you can achieve whatever your heart desires.
Look where the stars have brought you tonight.
Yes, they have.
Good luck. All right, we bring out Shannon Louise Smith from Orlando.
Good evening, Larry.
Good evening to you and to your cheering section out there. They're loud, okay. Shannon, Florida is currently going through the longest drought in history. Do you feel that there should be stricter guidelines on the use of water by both families and businesses?
Absolutely, and actually in Jacksonville where I live, we do have water guidelines. So you can only water your grass at certain times a day, especially in the evening. I think it's very important. Our environment, we need to respect our environment and understand that water is our greatest resource and very, very much the most important thing we have. So I think water guidelines are extremely important, definitely.
Makes us take a step back and check into reality. We live in Florida. We're surrounded by water, and yet we're having a water drought right now.
I know. We need to take care of our environment so we'll have it for many more years to come.
Very well said, Shannon. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
All right, what do you say we bring out Kristen Lee Duren from Panama City Beach? Hi, Kristen. Boy, you're here fast.
How are you?
I'm doing good. Not as good as you, but... All right, if you were president, Kristen, what would be the most important change you would make in our country?
Well, I think the most important change in our country is that we make sure that our parents get very involved in our children's lives. I'm very passionate about children, and I think they need a strong foundation to start life with. They need just a heads up on everything from the very beginning. I think our parents need to get very involved from day one. That way they can get a good education and have a strong life.
So a strong education and a strong family would be your platform.
Exactly.
Sounds like a good one to me. Thank you, Kristen, and good luck to you tonight. Next, we have Erica Valdez representing Jacksonville. Hi, Erica.
Good evening.
All right, I have a question for you. Do you feel that television and music should be censored more strictly in regards to children and teens?
Absolutely. I feel that nowadays there's too much exposure to things that children are not at an age to view. I think that parents need to monitor more carefully what their children watch, only because they need to be when they're at a young age, they need to watch things that are age appropriate. And the older that they get, then they can be exposed to more things. So I'm totally for ratings. Music should be censored. I absolutely agree with having censorship on CDs, tapes, because a lot of times parents don't know exactly what their children are listening to. And with those types of labels, it helps them to identify those types of things better.
And it's up to the parents to take an active role.
Absolutely. In fact, I want to become a family attorney, specializing in maintaining crucial family relationships. And I think, unfortunately, in America, that's deteriorating nowadays. And I think that a lot of that starts from parents not knowing what their kids are listening and watching on TV.
All right. Thank you very much, Erica, and good luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
All right. We're going to bring out Krista Gail Ballard. How you doing, Krista?
I am on top of the world right now. I'm having the best time of my life.
I can tell. You're just busting, aren't you? Krista, who's been your mentor and how has that person influenced you?
believe my mentor has been my dad. He has brought us through so much, and I just love him to death. And I just can't express the love that I have for him. He has taken care of my family unbelievably. Thank you.
Thank you. Getting all choked up. That's nice. She loves your dad.
Yes, I do. Definitely.
He's out there rooting for you. Good luck tonight. Very emotional. I get teary-eyed. Okay, we've just interviewed the first 7 semifinalists vying for the crown. You can see why these women are, in fact, the leaders of tomorrow. We got 8 more waiting backstage, and the questions when the Miss Florida USA pageant continues right back after this.
Here's
don't go away.
Miss USA trivia for all you pageant fans. The first Miss USA pageant that was held separately from Miss Universe took place in 1960 in South Florida. Until then, all countries and states were on their own, competing for the titles the same night. So now you know. Up next is the conclusion of the interview competition here on the Miss Florida USA 2002.
Are you watching the competition thinking, this looks like a lot of fun? Well then call the pageant hotline or surf the web to MissFloridaUSA.com and join the excitement. Like being at a live TV event, winning great prizes, and who knows, you just may be the next Miss USA. Preliminary pageants all around the state are forming and the opportunity of a lifetime awaits. It could happen to you, but you have to call to win.
Hi, I'm Darla Hahn, and here's a great new product that'll help your hair dry faster without damaging it. It's called the Turvy Twist.
Just wrap it over your wet hair, twist the tail until it's secure, then just flip and tuck it through the loop. Bath towels are so heavy, you can strain your neck. It's perfect if an unexpected package arrives or when reading a book. Kids love the Turvy Twist, too. Use it outside to protect your hair from the sun.
Turvy Twist is cleverly designed to keep your hair out of your face.
Applying makeup or a mask is easier than ever, and it protects your hair during hot baths. Save on laundry, too. It's so light and secure, you'll forget you're wearing it. Similar products cost up to $15 each. Call now, and you'll get 2 Turvy Twists for $19.99. But if you call in the next 10 minutes as part of a special offer, we'll double the value. That's 4 for just $19.99, less than $5 each.
So call the number on the bottom of your screen right now.
Have your credit card ready. Call 1-800-654-5050. Call in the next 10 minutes, get 4 Turvy Twists for only $19.99. This offer won't last. Call now.
Hey, you web surfers, want to check out the coolest teen pageant site on the net? TheFloridaTeenUSA.com. It takes you to the pageant and beyond, all at one site. Applications, information, behind-the-scenes recaps, and chat and bulletin boards that keep you up to date with all the fun that is Miss Florida Teen USA. It's chill, it's fun. It's TheFloridaTeenUSA.com. It's all about pageantry and me. And of course, check out my sister pageant at MissFloridaUSA.com. It's all about the competition.
When it comes to pageant competition, it doesn't get any tougher than interviews at the Miss Florida USA pageant.
It's really fun to watch these young women dance on their feet. Think about it, a live audience, 2 million home viewers, the judges. It surely makes a job interview look easy.
And that's what makes this event special. Talk about personal growth. These ladies can do anything after this challenge.
They surely can. Louie, now you have quite the challenge.
Oh, yeah, and I'm up for the challenge, Kristen. Let's continue with our contestants. We're going to bring out number 8 right now. She is Shanna Ray Green from Orlando. Hi, Shanna.
Hi, Louie.
How you doing?
I am so excited.
Okay, well, here's your question. Do you feel that cosmetic surgery is an unfair advantage in pageant competition?
I don't think it's unfair, but I think it's unfair to the girl herself. I believe that everyone's beautiful on the outside as well as the inside, and they should be confident in their self.
And no matter what you do to your outside, if you're not pretty on the inside, you can't really cover that up, can you?
That's right. It can't be covered.
Well, I'm sure that you're beautiful inside. I know you're beautiful outside. Good luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
All right, we have more interviews to come. Beginning with Jacqueline Neshwat from Umatilla. Hi, Jacqueline.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you doing? That's the question.
I'm doing wonderful.
Keeping it together. Okay, here comes the question. Do you think that so much emphasis should be placed on standardized test scores when considering applicants for college admission?
I think that is a very important component
I also feel that they should look at the whole package, the students' extracurricular activities as well, their past experience in high school. They have a nice clean record, and also their standardized test scores. So I think they need to focus on the whole package of the student, not just the test scores.
Why do you think that is, that they should look at the extracurricular activities and the whole package?
Well, maybe somebody's taking a test and has a bad day, and I don't want to judge them just for, you know, that one day they made a mistake. And, you know, there's many, many smart students out there, and if they just have, you know, the right role models and the right education, they can prove that they're just as well as straight A students.
Very well said. Thank you, Jacqueline.
Thank you.
Good luck tonight. All right, let's bring out, she's already here, Amy Nicole Bonfleur from Panama City Beach. Hello, Amy Nicole.
Hello, Louis.
All right, your question is, as a woman, what pressures do you face in your life and how do you alleviate them?
Well, I think all women face pressures such as the categorizing them as needing to be housewives or be in the kitchen. And as a woman, I do not do either of those, actually. I have a job, I play sports, I work, I do all kind of things. So that's how I overcome it, and I think that's a big problem with women nowadays.
So you're a modern woman, a working woman.
Oh, yeah.
Not saying anything bad about those who choose to stay at home.
Oh, no, not at all. I think mothers, it's good for them to be at home, actually, but that's just something that people are categorizing. All women should do that, and I don't think that's how it should be at all.
All right, good for you, and good luck tonight.
All right, thank you.
And on the crowd erupts and cheers for Danielle Wasser representing Broward County. Hi, Danielle.
Hello.
Danielle, this is your question. With such an emphasis on weight loss in today's society, what is your opinion on nutrition versus dieting?
I think there is a big difference between nutrition and dieting. A lot of young women and men these days are focusing so hard on being physically fit. America has placed such emphasis on this. You can become physically fit by having a healthy diet, eating well, exercising. That would be the nutritional part, versus the other, which is kind of the wrong way of going about it. A lot of people are starving themselves or anorexic and develop serious issues. So I think if people want to lose weight and stay healthy, nutrition and looking at it from the healthy point of view is definitely the best way to go.
Works for me. Does it work for you?
Works for me.
Oh, yeah, I can tell. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
All right, Danielle. And now we'll bring out Melanie Hill from Jacksonville. Hello, Melanie.
Good evening.
Great to be here.
Yes, great to see you here.
Thank you.
Melanie, do you think that government should legislate morality to provide a better environment to children to grow up in?
You know what? That's a very tricky question, but I've got a great answer for that.
All right, let's hear it.
I absolutely do agree with that. Today's society is so pressured against morals, the way people discipline themselves, the way they carry themselves within a society. And today we see so many of our politicians coming into the media with very tricky situations that they're involved in, and I think that negatively affects our society as well as our children. The politicians and anyone else that is a role model affect the way that our children view themselves, their perspectives in our country, and I think that this is something we really need to regulate within America so that as a country we can really position ourselves as the nation's leader that we are.
Very delicately put and very well said. Melanie Hill, great luck today.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.
Have fun. We're all having fun. We're going to bring out Shelby Burns in just a second right now from St. Petersburg. Hello, Shelby. We're not going to talk tennis, even though I want to.
Okay.
Your question is, how will being involved in this pageant help you to attain your specific career goals?
Well, I think that everyone is talking about personal growth. And for me, a quote that I've learned from my mother is, the most unfortunate thing that can happen to a person who fears failure is that he limits himself by becoming afraid to try anything new. And for me, if I had feared failure in this pageant, I wouldn't be here right now, elated as I am.
Now, explain that. Why did you fear failure coming over here?
Because look at these girls. They're beautiful and they're intelligent and they're leaders of tomorrow. Absolutely.
And look at yourself. You fit right along with the rest of them in that category.
Thank you very much.
Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
All All right, we have two more contestants to go. The next is Carrie-Anne Miwok from St. Petersburg. Hello, Carrie-Anne.
Hi, Louie.
How you doing?
Fantastic. How are you?
I'm good. I got your question. Do you feel that parents should be held accountable for their children's acts of violence?
I think this is a question that cannot be answered with a blanket response. I think it's very important for us to look at each situation individually. Obviously, there are situations where the parents have been negligent. In many cases, we've seen parents who've left guns out available to children, parents who have made these things available to children and not been responsible for their actions. However, we do know that teenagers can be very manipulative, and even the best of parents are often faced with situations of children they can't control. So I think in those instances where we can be very sure that the parents were responsible, they should absolutely be held accountable.
Very well said. Thank you, Carrie-Anne, and good luck tonight. All right. Our final contestant, Shannon L. Ford, representing Miami. Hello, Shannon.
How are you, Louie?
I'm good. You ready for your question?
Absolutely.
Okay, here goes. Do you feel that minorities, especially women, should receive special preferences for school and job opportunities?
You know, this is a great question for me because I am a human resources recruiter. And I face, different people every day that come into my office looking for a job. And let me tell you that I look at them all the same. If they are qualified and they can do the job and they have the experience, then I'll hire them, no matter what color, race, sex, anything that they are.
It's all about the person and what he or she can do.
Exactly.
And you do fabulous things, I'm told.
Thank you very much.
Good luck tonight.
Thank you, Louie.
All 15 ladies did an amazing job with this part of the competition. You can see why this is the premier title in the Sunshine State. Congratulations, ladies, again on a job well done. Ladies, up to you.
And a good job to you too, Louie. In our host city of Hollywood, we have the best beaches in the state.
And on assignment to explore the beach is our reigning queen, Julie, and her contestant reporters. An adventure is always in store.
Kristen, you know the beach is rocking today. We've got some contestant reporters. The sun, the sand, and lots of tanning lotion. Ladies, your mission, if you choose, is to find out what makes Hollywood Beach the best beach in South Florida. Be careful out there.
Such a lovely day. How about hooky instead?
Ah, help! Help! Not the boot camp!
Julie, check it out. My favorite part of Hollywood Beach is the Bed and Breakfast District. Let's take a walking tour. It's a charming, distinctly South Florida area with the feel of the beach and the sand in your shoes. What a great place for a getaway weekend. I'm just loving the luxury life. Marissa, how's the beach?
Come on, Miss Beauty Queen, you can pull and come pull, pull.
As for me, I'm an outdoors girl, and I love the natural habitats of Hollywood. From hiking to biking, I'm totally in touch with nature here in Hollywood, and the waterways are wonderful for a canoe trip on a day like this. And here at the Ann Cole Nature Center, you can learn about the natural wildlife of the region. I sure wish Marissa was here.
I'll let you know what you think. Keep going, keep going.
Now, sitting at the beach is what I call the perfect day. Pass the tanning butter. But the beach is not just about sun. And we have volleyball tournaments, triathlons, festivals, and even a fitness boot camp for those inclined. World-class dance is featured with the Ocean Dance Series. How cultural. But Marissa is as graceful as a dancer. But we can't find her. Marissa?
One more, come on.
Well, since we can't find Marissa, I'll just have to take you down the Hollywood Broadwalk myself. The Broadwalk is a breathtaking stroll down palm-lined beaches where hotels, restaurants, and retail shops await those inclined for a unique Hollywood experience. As for me, the best part of the beach is sitting at Ocean Alley just watching the world pass by. This is why I love being the queen. Now I wonder, whatever became of Marissa? Oh well, from Hollywood Hollywood Beach, this Miss Florida USA is saying, I love the beach life. Adalmas, it is a queen's world. Ciao.
Yes, it is a queen's life, Julie. And you too can be in her shoes by visiting MissFloridaUSA.com and entering online. It's that easy.
And that's easy. But the swimsuit competition surely isn't. And that's soon to follow in our pursuit of Miss Florida USA 2002.
The best pageantry in the Sunshine State is right around the corner. We'll be right back.
Winning the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant was like a dream. The prizes, the glamour. Being in the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant is awesome. And a $40,000 college scholarship ensures my college education. Yes, a $40,000 scholarship for college. Check out MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the details. So surf the web, enter online, and that could be you wearing my crown.
When the competition is as tough as it is in the Miss Florida USA pageant, the selection of qualified judges is crucial.
All the judges are leaders in their industries. The perfect judge, though, can not only select the most outstanding representative, but also help our contestants' career goals.
From talent agents to entertainment moguls, our prior judges have produced a legacy of outstanding Miss Florida USA winners.
Present company included.
Likewise. Louis, introduce us to this year's judging panel, please.
It'll be my pleasure. Thank you, Adalmas and Kristen. I ask the audience to please hold your applause until we have announced our entire judging panel. Our first judge is the Executive Vice President of the Heat Group, responsible for bringing special events to the American Airlines Arena. He is also former president of Miss Universe Incorporated, Mr. Mike Walker. Our next judge promotes entertainment production in Broward County. Please welcome the Broward Alliance's Vice President of Film and Television, Elizabeth Wentworth. One of Broward's premier attorneys with the firm Furtick & Grambling, he is also a gubernatorial appointee to the board of Broward County Community College, Mr. Levi Williams, Jr. A member of the first family of pyrotechnics as vice president of Zambelli Fireworks and a former Miss Pennsylvania USA herself, Marcy Zambelli Fumagalli. Our next judge is a leader in the South Florida music and television industry. He also specializes in licensing and artist placement. Entertainment attorney, David Berkison. When it comes to modeling or acting, our next judge develops and guides aspiring talent. She is the head of the TV film division for industry leader Irene Marie. She's Allie Newhoff. Our final judge is one of the leaders of the real estate boom in Central Florida as the owner of Engel Realty in Lakeland. He is also on the University of South Florida Foundation Board. Please welcome Mr. Gene Engel. Now, how about a round of applause for our hard-working judges? Thank you.
With one-third of the competition down, how are your choices at home doing?
Well, after the interviews, it's natural to have your favorites, but the swimsuit and the evening gown competitions are ahead, so your favorites may change.
Let's find out who wins your vote and the judges' vote in the swimsuit competition next year, Miss Florida USA 2002. But first, here's a message about education from our friends at the Florida Lottery.
The corner gas station on Route 818 moves at a pretty slow pace, but every now and then you'll see a line form. It's people like Jim Wilson buying lottery tickets. Thanks to folks all across the state, the lottery has been able to contribute more than $10 billion to help support education initiatives since 1988. Money that sends tomorrow's leaders to college today on Bright Futures scholarships, and hundreds of millions of dollars in bonds for new school construction and renovation. It's true. When you play, we all win.
Winning the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant was like a dream. The prizes, the glamour. Being in the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant is awesome. And a $40,000 college scholarship ensures my college education. Yes, a $40,000 scholarship for college. Check out MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the details. So surf the web, enter online, and that could be you wearing my crown.
I wanted to be a nurse since I was 6, but I was a little afraid about moving away to go to college. So when I found I could get my degree and still live at home, I registered at BCC the next day. Now I'm a nurse with a good job. Gracias, BCC.
An associate degree from BCC can put you to work in just 2 years. Learn the skills you need to get the job you want. Registration is going on now. Want to go? Got a call. Broward Community College, opening doors to a brighter future.
Want to keep up with all the latest information on Miss Florida USA? MissFloridaUSA.com has everything you need to know at one site. Preliminary pageant links, information, contestant applications, the latest Miss Florida USA news, and of course, behind-the-scenes photos. Then visit our Miss Florida Teen USA page at MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the latest on our sister pageant. So, for the latest pageant info, just find us at MissFloridaUSA.com, the coolest pageant site on the internet.
The 2002 Miss Florida USA pageant is brought to you by the City of Hollywood, the Diamond of the Gold Coast, the Greater Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, and Golf Hollywood. For more information on how you can become Miss Florida USA or Miss Florida Teen USA, visit MissFloridaUSA.com.
From Bailey Concert Hall in Broward County, here are your pageant experts, Adamus Vidal and Kristen Ludicky.
Well, the pageant resumes with the swimsuit competition, a test of fitness and dedication to being the best that each contestant can be.
In the next 5 minutes, we're about to see the culmination of months of hard work in the gym, a schedule full of aerobics, personal trainers, and definitely no ice cream.
Not at all. Kristen, what are the contestants thinking backstage right now?
Probably about ice cream.
Sure.
No, just kidding. Well, for me, the interviews were the time to focus and think on your feet, which is not easy in a theater environment. So in contrast, when you reach the swimsuits, you just react to the audience and be thankful that all of the hard work in the gym paid off.
Well, so who will take control of the swimsuit competition and take a step closer to the title? Let's see, Louie.
We're going to find out in just a moment, because with designs by Richie's Swimwear, here they are, our 15 semifinalists ready to hit the stage in the swimsuit competition. Beginning with April Gregory from Cape Coral. From Pompano Beach, welcome Robin Kay. Our third semifinalist is Barbara Del Pilar from Tampa. Give it up for Shannon Louise Smith, representing Orlando. Our fifth semifinalist is Kristen Lee Duren from Panama City Beach. Representing Jacksonville, give it up for Erica Valdez. Oh.
From Ocala, please welcome Krista Gail Ballard. Finalist is Shanna Ray Green from Orlando. Semifinalist number 9 is Jacqueline Neshwa from Umatilla. Together for Amy Nicole Bonfleur from Panama City Beach. Our 11th semifinalist is Daniel Wasser representing Broward County. Continue with number 12, Melanie Hill from Jacksonville. Lucky 13 is Shelby Burns from St. Petersburg. Semi-finalist, Carrie Ann Miwa, representing Daytona Beach. And let's give it up for Shannon L. Ford, representing Miami. Let me bring ladies out one more time for comparison judging. There they are. Yeah. Presenting the semifinalists for the title of Miss Florida USA 2002. Kristen, take it away.
Wow, Chris. Wow, Kristen, they made it look so easy.
You know, it may have looked easy, though, but I'm sure that those 15 contestants did so well because of all the tough competition. I'm sure they spent many, many hours in the gym, that's for sure. But you know what? When that last girl leaves the stage, all of the focus then is on running and getting that special gown ready.
Kristen, I actually think I can hear the heels as they run backstage. You know, the thought of going from swimsuit to gown in such a quick time is totally nerve-wracking. Any secrets?
Well, I think the secret is preparation. Before the competition, I had selected every little detail, such as hose, shoes, my dress, accessories, everything. And yes, I even practiced changing it so that it was down to an art form by the time the pageant was here. Believe me, if you saw those girls move back there, they're truly athletes.
I'm tired just thinking about it.
Me too.
But gowns are traditionally the coolest part of the pageant. The style, grace, and fashion, that is the evening gown competition. It's up next here at Miss Florida USA 2002.
As the evening gown segment is next, how about a little pageant trivia on the most popular competition in pageantry? Up until the mid-50s, it was not unusual for pageant queens to be crowned in their swimsuits. But after the spectacular royal inauguration of England's Queen Elizabeth, it has become accustomed to crown each pageant queen in their formal wear. Believe me when I say all of our contestants look like royalty in the evening gown competition. And that begins next on Miss Florida USA 2002.
Are you watching the competition thinking, this looks like a lot of fun? Well, then call the pageant hotline or surf the web to MissFloridaUSA.com and join the excitement. Like being at a live TV event, winning great prizes, and who knows, you just may be the next Miss USA. Preliminary pageants all around the state are forming, and the opportunity of a lifetime awaits. It could happen to you, but you have to call to win.
Welcome back to the Miss Florida USA pageant. Between the pageant week, fashion shows, television pre-tapings, and preparations, our contestants have had the chance to get together and have some fun out on the town.
And you know, fun on the town they had in our host city of Hollywood. And you know, the cameras were right there with them to capture all the action.
Adalmas, this is where it all begins, the Spring Hill Suites. It's the contestants' home away from home. And it all starts now. True, it's a hectic schedule, and it starts here at registration, but our girls love the pace. However, at poolside, you can see some contestants working on those last-minute tans and preparing their luxurious suites for the competition. Better hurry, ladies. Dinner is just around the corner. And the first order of pageant week was getting acquainted at O'Hara's Jazz Club in downtown Hollywood. The food was outstanding, the music great, and our contestants felt like pageant royalty as every attention was placed upon them. And you know we love to be pampered. I love jazz, but it's early to bed as the pressures of pageant week are just beginning. When the pressure gets great during competition week, there's always golf.
Here at the Miss Florida USA Open, the competition is tough. We are at the final hole of the Hollywood Beach Golf and Country Club. Up on the tee is Hiroshima Kindelin.
Well, luckily golf is not part of the competition. But Hollywood does have some great golf challenges. Gotta go. After a very tough day at golf, our contestants enjoy their evening at beaches at the Holiday Inn Hollywood Beach Resort. They checked out the tropical setting, did a little sightseeing at the beach, and then enjoyed a fantastic meal. Once again, these women were treated like the belles of the ball. But they better not eat too much, because tomorrow is the much-anticipated press photo day. Ah, yes, press photo day, the traditional day of posing for photographs and interviews with the international press. And the Comfort Inn pool is the perfect site for the festivities. With so many different looks of beauty here at Miss Florida USA, a photographer can have quite a field day taking pictures. They are hardworking members of the press, after all. As the ladies said goodbye to the photographers, this week isn't over by a long shot. The unsung hero of Pageant Week is Quality Transportation Services. They keep us cool, comfortable, and on time. And in a contestant's life, timing is everything. One of the best chances to mingle at Miss Florida USA is riding to all the special events. I'm here with my new friend Amy.
Buddy.
Quality Transportation Services. Thanks for the memories. The final memory of Pageant Week is of Bimini Boatyard. What a fun night that was. I could just imagine one of these beautiful yachts being mine, but until that day, I'll just have to settle for some good seafood. And that is what the Bimini Boatyard served. Our contestants really got a taste of the tropical spirit that defines South Florida. As we say goodbye to Pageant Week, We lead the tropics in casual attire for formal gowns and competition. Ladies, was it fun?
Yeah!
Kristen and Adalmas, what a pageant week it was.
Kristen, Julie gets all the cool assignments.
She does. But you know what, Adalmas? I wouldn't trade places with anyone right now, especially knowing that the evening gown competition is about to begin.
Well, how about giving our viewers at home some advice on making their choices in the competition?
Well, just remember, it's not the dress that wins the title. It's the girl in the dress. It doesn't matter if it's designer or if it's off the rack. It's all about the young lady being on, meaning looking great, feeling great, and confident on stage.
You know, it's the combination of perfect hair, dress, makeup, walk, and crowd.
And sometimes you know you just ace the competition. And we'll see this tonight as the contestants are ready to show the audience they came to compete.
Louis, let's check out the fashions.
All righty, I'm ready. We're going to begin. Here's a setup. The contestants choose their own gowns and designs and accessories. And that's what makes it so much fun for us. But I imagine a little nerve-wracking for the contestants. We begin with our parade of contestants, followed by tonight's top 15 semifinalists. Here we go. Our first semifinalist, once again, April Gregory. April is from Cape Coral and attends Florida Gulf Coast University. Next, we have Robin Kay from Pompano Beach. Robin's a graduate of Palm Beach Atlantic. Already a successful model, she's visited so many countries, including Peru, England, Scotland, and Germany. Tampa, Barbara del Pilar. Barbara's a graduate of the University of South Florida. She describes herself as ambitious, compassionate, and dedicated. Can you do my love? Representing Orlando, we have Shannon Louise Smith. Shannon's a graduate of Clemson University. She has her black belt in Taekwondo and has competed at both state and national levels. She's also a dancer for the Jaguars in the NFL. Semifinalist number five is Kristen Lee Duran from Panama City Beach. Kristen's a graduate of the University of Alabama. She thinks the most important message a title holder can convey, that is up to you to determine who you are, who you will become. Beauty is not found in the crown, but within the heart of the one who wears it. Jacksonville. Give it up for Erica Valdez. Erica is a graduate of Florida State University. She loves FSU football. Seventh semi-finalist is Krista Gail Ballard from Ocala. Krista Gail goes to Daytona Beach Community College. She's already a very accomplished photographer, also involved in cheerleading, ballet, and plays the recorder and the dulcimer. More to go, beginning with Shanna Ray Green from Orlando. Shanna Ray goes to the University of Central Florida. She's finishing up a major in radio and television and hopes to one day become a news anchor. From Umatilla, please welcome Jacqueline Neshwat. Jacqueline goes to Stetson University. One of her unique talents is that she knows how to belly dance, and very well. What she treasures most, though, are her family values. Our 10th semifinalist is Amy Nicole Bonfleur from Panama City Beach. Amy Nicole attends Gulf Coast College. She's already an accomplished dancer, 17 years of dance training, tap, jazz, ballet. Representing Broward County, give it up for Danielle Wasser. Danielle is a graduate of the University of Florida. She's got a degree in broadcast communications and business. The message is never give up on your dreams, because through dedication, they can become a reality. Jacksonville, Miss Melanie Hill. Melanie is a graduate of the University of Phoenix. She's got a BA in business management. Something that she recently learned about herself is that her personal boundaries are endless. From St. Petersburg comes our 13th semifinalist. Welcome back, Shelby Burns. Shelby is a graduate student at the University of Florida. Greatest accomplishment is acting as a spokesperson for Parkinson's disease. Next, we have Carrie Ann Miwa representing Daytona Beach. Carrie Ann attended the University of Florida. Now she's transferring to the University of Miami's College of Medicine in the fall, but she says she'll always be a Gator in her heart. Representing Miami, Shannon L. Ford. Shannon goes to Florida International University. She's been dancing since she was just 3 years old, and she's put all that dancing to use. You can see her on the football field as one of the Miami Dolphins cheerleaders. Thank you, Shannon. Our semifinal competition is now complete. The judges are very busy right now, very arduously working, picking their top five semifinalists. How about you guys at home? Compare your picks to ours as we reveal the survivors of our pageant adventure. Coming up next, right here on Miss Florida USA 2002.
The corner gas station on Route 818 moves at a pretty slow pace, but every now and then you'll see a line form. It's people like Jim Wilson buying lottery tickets. Thanks to folks all across the state, the lottery has been able to contribute more than $10 billion to help support education initiatives since 1988. Money that sends tomorrow's leaders to college today on Bright Futures scholarships, and hundreds of millions of dollars in bonds for new school construction and renovation. It's true. When you play, we all win.
When it comes to being Miss Florida USA, life can be pretty good for the winner. Many opportunities are available with the title.
And our reigning queen, Julie Donaldson, is an example of how a young lady can take the crown and succeed. So many good things to look forward to, like networking with our state leaders, job opportunities, visibility, and of course, the chance to be Miss USA.
And here's all the sides of our Julie, and she's going to show us another part of being the queen.
Adelmas, another advantage of being Miss Florida USA is I am always at fun events. Gotta tell ya, I like that part. Case in point, I'm here at concert nights at the Hollywood Bandshell, one of many celebrations of a Hollywood lifestyle that fits my many sides. Hey, I'm a complex girl. One side of me loves the festivals and celebrations. We have Mardi Gras, Wingdings, and Jazz Fests, and it all takes place in Hollywood. So what about my cultural side? Here at Hollywood's Art and Cultural Center, cutting edge modern art plays on my inner artist. Here at the Hollywood Central Performing Arts Center, dance takes my cultural level a step higher. Hey, I can do that. All the world's a stage, but we are merely players here at the Hollywood Playhouse. Hey, did I pass the audition? And what about outdoor, Julie? Hollywood's Parks and Trails features the best of what outdoor Florida has to offer. Okay, so I'm not much of the outdoors type. That's why I brought in some willing contestants to go explore the area. Ladies, go get them. It's you, baby. It's you, baby. What a workout. I'm exhausted just watching. This lounge chair is more the type of outdoor life that I enjoy. It should always be this good. Speaking of good, my philanthropic side enjoys helping such outstanding charities as the Boys and Girls Club of Hollywood, amongst many important causes. Helping others is a good thing. We're all friendly neighbors here at Miss Florida USA. And that leads me to my favorite meet. I call it Star Jewelry. And here in Hollywood, the entertainment industry has found a home as PBS, Warner Brothers, and now Miss Florida USA have moved into the neighborhood. Not to mention the fact that The Other Hollywood makes feature films here regularly. Adelmas and Kristen, I am a natural star. Until I'm famous, I'll have to appease my spa side here at the Diplomat Resort. After this manicure, I'll get back to work and model our prizes. I am loving the pampered life.
I definitely envy her. But Julie is a great example of taking an opportunity like Miss Florida USA and really making something out of it.
You know, pageants are so much about personal growth and achieving goals. You too can join in and become Miss Florida USA and change your life.
That's right. Personal growth and reaching your dreams are great things, but I like the prizes, you know.
You do.
Julie, are you up to showing off your new modeling talents with this year's prizes?
So you want something special in the prize segment. Well, I brought international fashion photographer Bob Lasky in on this one. And since I am a working model, I say let's rock. You in on this, Bob?
Hey, let's shoot this.
You're on. The shoot got off to a royal start in this beautiful gown by Regalia. Tonight's winner will receive a great formal look to the tune of a $2,500 fashion wardrobe. The cut on this Tadashi gown makes it one of my favorites. You always feel like a queen in fashions from Regalia. But what about jewelry? Well, Carol's Jewelers had that covered. Our new Miss Florida USA will be the envy of any model with this beautiful necklace designed just for her. Carol's Jewelers, en la solas. Bob then suggested something beachy, and Richie Swimwear has that under control. I told some of my friends about Richie's. They loved the styles and colors, and who could blame them? They had fun on the beach. Alas, I had to work. But Miss Florida USA does get a really cool beach wardrobe from Richie's. Bob thought I should have more looks. I wonder if this is what he had in mind. With Deborah's, it's easy to show your many fashion styles. From a more casual look to a suit perfect for business, Deborah's will wardrobe our new Miss Florida USA. And you know she'll be the belle of the ball in her special gown from Deborah's. The key to being Miss Florida USA is certainly the ability to accessorize. Nobody does that like Bijou Turner. Jewelry designed for your every mood and style. That's Bijou Turner. My next call was once again formal, and wouldn't you know, everyone wanted to help me model this prize. Bob was up to the task, so was I, in this glamorous evening wear from the new collection by Scala. Sophisticated designs and a fresh-spirited attitude will make every woman feel sensational. Affordable elegance from Scala. But some prizes I won't share with my friends. And that would be this elegant mink coat from the Fur Salon at Saks Fifth Avenue. Bold new shapes and vibrant colors are this season's trademark. Whether you're looking for a sophisticated sable or fun featherweight sheared furs, the Fur Salon at Saks Fifth Avenue has today's most exciting fur fashions. Who wouldn't love a fashion shoot with Bob Lasky? From the most important fashion magazines to Miss Florida USA, Photos by Lasky gives each a special look and feel, and a full photo session is awaiting our new queen, Lucky Lady. Well, Bob, I think we passed the audition.
I'd say we did.
What do you think, Adelmas?
Well, I think you definitely passed the audition, Julie. But now the work at hand is narrowing the group down to the final five contestants. Louis?
All right, I have the list right here in my hands. But before I read the names, I just want to say that all of the ladies, not just the 15 here on stage, are all very deserving of the title of Miss Florida 2002. Unfortunately, there can only be one going on to Miss USA. We'll start with the top five. Ready? All right, here we go. In random order, your top five finalists vying for Miss Florida USA 2002. Carrie Miwa. Our second finalist is Erica Valdez. Give it up for Shannon Smith. Our fourth finalist, Shannon Ford. And our fifth finalist, vying for the title of Miss Florida USA 2002, Jacqueline Neshwat. Congratulations to our top five finalists. Now it's time to take these five finalists and choose our new Miss Florida USA for 2002. You guys ready? Oh boy, I'm getting nervous now. How are your choices at home doing? Well, we're gonna come right back to answer those questions and so much more right here on Miss Florida USA.
Here's a little Miss Florida USA trivia for you. Our competitors tonight truly are at the head of the class. Tonight we have five contestants with master's degrees, two with law degrees, 12 contestants entering their senior years in college, and we even have a vice president in the corporate ranks. So yes, one day you may be working for one of these young women. And speaking of working, our top five take the stage to work it one more time for the judges, here on Miss Florida USA 2002.
I wanted to be a nurse since I was six, but I was a little afraid about moving away to go to college. So when I found I could get my degree and still live at home, I registered at BCC the next day. Now I'm a nurse with a good job. Gracias, BCC.
An associate degree from BCC can put you to work in just 2 years. Learn the skills you need to get the job you want. Registration is going on now. Wanna go? Gotta call. Broward Community College, opening doors to a brighter future. From the back to the
middle and around. Get ready to move. It's time to submit to the rhythm with Pulse. Two CDs or two cassettes of nonstop throbbing energy. You can't get this 30-track collection in any store. And get it now. To order, call the number on your screen. Two CDs, $26.99. Two cassettes, $21.99.
Winning the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant was like a dream. The prizes, the glamour. Being in the nationally televised Miss Teen USA pageant is awesome. And a $40,000 college scholarship ensures my college education. Yes, a $40,000 scholarship for college. Check out MissFloridaTeenUSA.com for all the details. So surf the web, enter online, and that could be you wearing my crown.
We're back live here at Bailey Concert Hall. Can you feel the excitement? Can you feel it?
Absolutely.
Oh man, it's like palpitating all over the place. I mean, we are this close to naming the next Miss Florida USA. Now, for you at home, as well as our judges, we present our five finalists once again. One will be the new Miss Florida USA. We begin with Carrie Miwa. Carrie represents Daytona Beach. Representing Jacksonville, Erica Valdez. Representing Orlando, Shannon Louise Smith. Representing Miami, Shannon L. Ford. And from Umatilla, the belly dancer, Jacqueline Neshwan. Congratulations again, ladies, all wonderful representatives of the Sunshine State, but only one will win and make it all the way to Miss USA. What do the pageant experts up there think? Ladies.
Well, I think I give them all thumbs up.
And each of them has visions of winning the crown. This could be the longest few minutes of their lives. I remember the feeling so well. Oh, the nerves. You know, they're all on stage right now congratulating each other, but deep down, they all want to win that title.
Of course, I know that. And each of them would be a wonderful representative. What about your favorite at home? It's time to make that final choice as a Miss Florida USA 2002 will be named after this commercial break.
The corner gas station on Route 818 moves at a pretty slow pace, but every now and then you'll see a line form. It's people like Jim Wilson buying lottery tickets. Thanks to folks all across the state, the lottery has been able to contribute more than $10 billion to help support education initiatives since 1988. Money that sends tomorrow's leaders to college today on Bright Futures scholarships, and hundreds of millions of dollars in bonds for new school construction and renovation. It's true. When you play, we all win.
Live from Bailey Concert Hall, and we're about to announce the new Miss Florida USA.
But before we select our new Miss Florida USA, let's look back with Julie Donaldson on what a fantastic year it has been. This is one woman you're going to want to keep your eyes on.
That's right.
Thanks, Kristen. What a special moment in life that was. To be Miss Florida USA 2001 is something I worked very hard for. From the moment I walked off the stage, my life changed. Being a broadcast major, the chance to work in front of the camera was wonderful. From telethons to working on shows like Tonight's or What I Want to Do for a Living. The title has allowed me to help my community and give something back. Sometimes I even get to walk the red carpet, but it all makes me feel good about helping others. And what about this entrance as I tried skydiving? And on the water, the Winterfest Boat Parade was an amazing night in Broward County. Yes, these are truly memories of a lifetime. Alas, Adamus and Kristen, I am to give up my crown. But being Miss Florida USA is something that will always be a part of me. Well, Louie's about to call me out for my final walk. So best wishes to the next Miss Florida USA. God bless.
Wow, Julie, it's hard to imagine the year has gone by. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed an honor and my pleasure to present Miss Florida USA 2001, the lovely Julie Donald.
From the moment I was crowned Miss Florida USA, my life has been enriched beyond what I had ever dreamed imaginable.
I would like to first and foremost thank Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, for blessing me with a life surrounded by love. It is only through him that I was capable of fulfilling my dream of becoming Miss Florida USA. My year would not have been possible if I did not have the love and support of my wonderful family and many old and new friends. With all my heart and soul, I thank you. To the Miss Florida USA family, your guidance has given me the opportunity to achieve my goals professionally and individually. I look forward to a bright future with you all. Finally, I want to encourage all the delegates to find your passion in life and dare to live it. Life is a blessing that we need to embrace, share, and learn from. May God's blessings be with you all.
Okay, this is it, the moment of truth. Are we ready, judges? Ha! Holding out on me, are you? Okay, here they are, the results as presented by Ron Turner from the firm of Tate & Company Certified Public Accountants. Now, before I announce the names of our four finalists, and the new Miss Florida USA, it is obvious that any one of you would be a wonderful representative for our state, and we wish you all the very best of luck, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. It's been wonderful working with you guys for the past 2 days. All right, now let's find out who our winner is. Our fourth runner-up is Carrie Miwa. Our third runner-up is Erica Valdez. Our second runner-up is Shannon Smith. Okay, before we announce our winner, let's take a moment with our final two contestants. Okay, what are you guys feeling right now?
I'm thinking I wish you stopped talking to us and just tell us who won.
What do you say? Should I shut up? All right, here we go. The ladies have spoken. The first runner-up for Miss Florida USA 2002 is Jacqueline Neshwat. Shannon Ford, you are the new Miss Florida USA. Congratulations. Represented Florida.
Congratulations, Shannon, as you embark on a year to remember. We look forward to watching you compete in the Miss USA pageant.
And what a year it will be. But for tonight's show, we want to thank everyone who has helped in the success of tonight's pageants. The judges, staff, parents, friends, and the people of Hollywood. It was a very special year.
And I am Idal Miss Vidal saying, join us this October for the Miss Florida Teen USA pageant. For Kristen, Louie, and myself, good night and good pageantry.
Good night.
The Miss Florida USA 2002 pageant was presented by the City of Hollywood, the Diamond on the Gold Coast, the Great Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, and Golf Hollywood. For information on preliminary pageant opportunities or how you can compete for the titles of Miss Florida USA or Miss Florida Teen USA, please call the pageant hotline at 1-800-USA-FLA1. or visit the pageant website at MissFloridaUSA.com or MissFloridaTeamUSA.com. It's where dreams become reality.
Hi, Sarah. I love you, baby. Oh, my God.
The official host hotels of Miss Florida USA 2002 are the Spring Hill Suites, the Comfort Inn, and the Hampton Inns of Fort Lauderdale. The contestants arrived on schedule thanks to the outstanding services of Quality Transportation, the official land carriers of Miss Florida USA 2002. Tonight's scenery was provided by Scene Stealers of Miami, state-of-the-art scenery and design. For information on how you can host an official preliminary pageant for Miss Florida USA, visit MissFloridaUSA.com.